Hello everyone, my name is Shradan Siraj and I'm currently working as an intern at Lexis and Company. Today we'll be discussing about the rights of a second wife. Marriage is an ancient tradition which is popular from Vedic period until now. With various modifications, it developed in a better way. In present, second marriage is void ab initio in the first marriage in substance. The law on such relationships made very clear that if the first marriage is legally wedded, that is, all the ceremonies including Saptapadi were performed, it is a valid marriage. If a person performs second marriage, he or she commits bigamy, which is a punishable offense. Bigamy is defined under section 494 of the Indian Penal Code. This law states that whoever marries with a person during such marriage, if former spouse is living, due to such reasons, such marriages are considered void, should be punished for such an offense. If the spouse marries more than one time during the life of the first husband or wife, he or she should be punished with imprisonment, which may extend 7 years, and shall also be liable for fine. The prosecution has to prove the following points to prove bigamy. The accused must be married. He must have contracted second marriage. Existence of former marriage should be proved. The former spouse must be alive. Both marriages must have completed necessary ceremonies and must be valid. The second wife is entitled to file a petition for declaring her marriage void. Here, the first wife has no rights to file a petition. Though there isn't any law in the country which contains any explicit provision or section which entitles second wives for maintenance, there are, however, laws, both secular and personal in character, which provide some scope for inclusion of second wives. Some of these laws which are applicable to Hindus are the Hindu Marriage Act 1955. The Hindu Marriage Act 1955 provides for maintenance for both husband and wife under Section 25. Section 25, on the face of it, does not contain anything which hints towards intention of legislature to include the second wife under its ambit. However, the courts in a few decisions have treated Section 25 as an enabling provision which allows discretion to the court to grant maintenance according to the facts and circumstances of a case. Hindu Adoptions and Maintenance Act 1956. Section 18 of the Hindu Adoptions and Maintenance Act provides for the maintenance of a wife by the husband. Section 18.2d of the Act reads that a Hindu wife would be entitled to maintenance from her husband while living separately if the husband has any other wife living. In the absence of any specific definition of wife under the said Act, the language of any section does not explicitly suggest that it seeks to cover only the legally wedded wife to be eligible for maintenance. The Protection of Women from Domestic Violence Act 2005. Section 12 of the Domestic Violence Act provides for monetary relief to the aggrieved party and does not mention the word wife. Section 2 of the Act defines an aggrieved party as a woman who has lived in a domestic relationship with the respondent. The definition for domestic relationship under the Act inter alia mentions it to be a relationship in the nature of marriage. The last is the Criminal Procedure Code, Section 125. Under Section 125 of CRPC, a magistrate can order a husband to maintain his wife. The object of Section 125 is to prevent vagrancy and destitution and to provide speedy remedy for the supply of food, clothing and shelter. In conclusion, the social stigma attached with being a second wife, the absence of any legal status to the relationship, and the enormous pain of being cheated into a marriage are undoubtedly extremely depressing for a woman. Even though there is no recognition given to a second wife due to the judicial interpretation of existing law as discussed above, she may have some chances of getting maintenance. In the absence of any clear provisions under the law, her chances of claiming her rights are largely dependent on the discretion of the judge. Even under the criminal law, it is extremely hard to prove bigamy, as the marriage has to be validly performed to prove the offense of bigamy. Usually, these loopholes in the law are exploited by the men to defend themselves in such cases. Given this background of contrasting legal precedents, lawmakers should make clear provisions to protect the rights of those women who have been duped into second marriages so as to bring them some respite. Thank you.